why should you study Bachelor of Science Health?
So who should study?
Yes. Yes.
Good question. I think from my experience teaching and also a previous career as an allied health professional, I think that people that should study science health are people that are curious about individuals, about groups, about the community around them. I like to think of our students as being both upstreamers and downstreamers, so people that want to understand how people get in the situations they do, and also thinking about how we can get involved and help people out in the community around us. So 100%. People that are curious about health and wellbeing.
100%. Can you do a major? What are the options?
You can. There's a plethora of opportunities, majors and minors, yeah, for students to explore. What are some of the majors that you did?
So I did movement science, mm-hmm, which was a physio type occupational type of anatomy major. So mm-hmm, it branched off really nicely into all the exercise physiology type units. But I had friends who did, you know, hearing and speech. There were a lot of health and public management as well as marketing people. So mm-hmm, they went specifically into the marketing form of health, which they've really enjoyed that in the type of health promotions area, which mm-hmm is really cool.
Excellent. And there's a great drop down on the website that tells you all of the majors, yeah, and minors that are available to you. So why choose University of Sydney?
This is a tricky one. when I went in as a first year, fresh year, I mean, the campus is amazing. I know that sounds very superficial, but I mean, the facilities were also amazing. I remember I got a tour of all the libraries, and I came from a really small high school as well. So even the fact that there was like more than one library just blew my mind. But then also the lecturers that gave, you know, the talks, they were quite well educated, but also like really friendly and approachable. And that was amazing. And they also were just so helpful with like any questions, because I was, you know, a ditzy 17-year-old. And I was like, what if I don't want to do it? What if I want to do this? And, you know, they actually spent the time, the whole 20 minutes that I took of their time, explaining everything to me, which I actually maybe didn't have that experience at the other unis as well, which, fine, time constraints. But yeah, this uni really gelled with me, and also their values, like honour and integrity and everything in their ethos, really aligned with mine as well. So that was one of the main reasons I chose it.
Excellent. And I think as first year coordinator, I get a lot of opportunities to meet those 17-year-old high school students. And I think that the fact that the workplace values putting people in a position to answer the silly questions or the dumb questions, yeah, or the questions when people are lost,
yeah,
I think it really demonstrates that we're looking at looking after people as well. So excellent.
So, Sarah, what are the entry requirements?
The entry requirements for science health are related to mathematics. So it's important for those that have finished year 12 or have year 12 equivalent that they've got either a band 4 in general mathematics or a band 3 in extension 1 and 2 mathematics.
Very sciencey. What career opportunities are there?
So many. I think twice a year we run a careers evening and we invite students back who've completed the degree, as well as talking to lecturers, because, you know, we've all been out there in the field working. And so we have people come back to talk about where they landed or where they are for the time being, because I think it's important to remember that many of us will have multiple careers in our lifetime. So some of them go on to study further into specific disciplines like physio and OT and speech pathologists. Some go into health research, some in health policy. We have students that end up in health management, and some that are still exploring the different places in terms of where their health skills can be best applied. Yeah. I think there's a lot of emerging work in e-health and, yeah, understanding how we can better service our community. And so a lot of our students are able to take that health curiosity and kind of branch out. I always think it's like tentacles, yeah, out there. They all end up in multiple places, either in frontline services or behind the scenes.
Yeah, it's funny you mentioned that, because I'm doing extra study, but all my friends have now graduated from the degree. And it's also really funny to see where they end up, because it isn't in places I would have imagined. Like one friend's in a lab doing cancer research, the other friend's working for the Greater Western Sydney Health District in health promotions and like physical activity type of stuff. So it's really cool to see where they've ended up, considering we all did the same degree.
Yes.
It's really cool.
And I think it's a really great sign that we have so many students that keep in touch with us and let us know how, yeah, they're going, and let us know, you know, what's working, what's not working, and where they might go to next. So I think, yeah, that that's a really nice sign too.
Are there any exchange opportunities?
There are. I think one of the important things to remember that we've been focusing on a lot is the diversity of health opportunities that this degree offers. So the exchange opportunities very much mirror that complexity. So there are opportunities that are shared with the students as they go along from year to year, and they can take up different opportunities depending on what their majors are, depending on what their interests are, and where they might head to next.
Yeah, I had a lot of friends who did exchange and it was the best. They always said it was the best time of their life in their degree. It was really funny because I went on holidays to see the people who were on exchange, and they were just, you know, I went to London and they were all in King's College in London.
Yes.
And, you know, the partnerships that the University of Sydney has all around the world is also amazing. Like, yeah, there's some pretty top-notch people.
Definitely. And I think the exchange opportunities are really great for students that want to solidify their skills. Mm-hmm. So to actually see what they've been learning about in practice and to view it from another community's mm-hmm. perspective. So that's really important too. Okay, so Alia, what social opportunities have you had?
Way too many. it's one of the great things about the University of Sydney is how many social opportunities there are. I mean, for me, I volunteer a lot. So, you know, there are programs to help volunteer, to help mentor disabled students to the program that I talked about before about the mentoring within our faculty. I now help coordinate that program. Mm. I mean, there are a lot of social opportunities in that sense that you can really work with teams and team build. On the flip side, for purely social aspects, there's about over 100 societies, and there's always something happening each week for whatever you want. There's the chocolate society, the tea society, movie nights, there's just everything. So if you ever did, and they're also a really great place to make friends. Mm. So you have like both the faculty type of social opportunities, which are really great, and then also just the broader university-wide opportunities, which are really good as well, because you broaden your own horizons by meeting all different people from all different degrees, and that's pretty something special.
Definitely. I think that the first year students that we see when they get to that first semester break between the semesters start to recognise how important the social aspect is and the mentoring opportunities too. So the fact that we have a mentoring scheme and we're able to connect the third year students with the first year students means that we can enhance that those kind of social connections that are just as important at university.
Yeah. Are there any scholarships available?
You're probably better placed to answer that because you're the scholarship person. Yes. But there are about 9 or 10 scholarships available to students depending on what their speciality is, what majors they've completed, and there's some generic health scholarships too. So they're all available on the website. But from your personal experience.
So I got a scholarship first year of uni, and that was amazing, and it was quite a bit of money, and I also got like a free iPad and all this other stuff, which was amazing for, you know, an 18-year-old kid. I remember just it was so daunting going onto the website because there were all of these scholarships, and I was like, which ones am I like able to go for? But you know, there are a lot, and it's I think about finding your niche as well, because like Sarah said, there's like tens of scholarships, and you know, I'm looking at postgraduate study even now, and I'm looking at all the scholarships that are available. So it's really about like zoning in on, you know, what you can apply for, and definitely like even I remember I had a chat with my careers advisor saying, you know, what am I able to pick, because like the University of Sydney's options are really quite endless, especially with scholarships, and they're always willing to help out a hand. And also, in addition to scholarships, we also have a lot of prizes in our faculty. So there's like a student leadership prize and all that other type of stuff, which I think fits into that niche.
Yes. And also people from diverse population groups. I think it's always important to recognise not only what your academic skills are, what your niche is, but also where you come from and what's available to you.
So the scholarship I got first year was actually for leadership opportunities. So that was really amazing. I did a lot of leadership stuff in high school, which was really cool to have that be recognised by the university.
Excellent.
That's it.
Thanks.